When you're derailed by stress or workload or other commitments, and all of a sudden you're kind of looking at your potential training day coming up, and it gets shorter and shorter and shorter, and now you're questioning whether or not you can actually get it in. I have four rules, and I didn't follow the first one when I used to be an Ironman person. I would always say it's all or nothing. If I can't do it completely, then it wasn't worthwhile, and it really manifested into a lot of issues where I mentally clobbered myself by saying, you know, if I didn't have a 90 minutes to run and I could shorten that to 45, it wasn't any good. And that was a real mistake. And I went through this roller coaster of psychological stress, and I could have controlled it. I'm going to tell you how to control it. First off, number one, I have a 20-minute rule, because in 20 minutes you can feel good about your exercise session. And a lot of you are going to say, well, 20 minutes doesn't do much. Yes, it will. Get out. Make sure that you write down the time. This is number two. You have to have a time, even on that stressful day. So you've got this 20 minutes. That's number one. Number two is write down the time, and write down a secondary time if you feel like everything's caving in and you're not going to be able to make that lunchtime run, 20 minutes. Have a secondary time, and it might be at 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock at the end of the day. When you do that and you put that down on your daily planner, all of a sudden you're committed to doing it. Number three, make sure you include at least one segment of higher intensity training. And I'll say training, but one segment where you're elevating your heart rate from 25 seconds to 2 minutes. Typically, you do this at the end before you do a short cool down. And when you do that, you get this huge perfusion of blood. Your stroke volume wants to blow your heart out. That's a good thing. You're not going to get an amplitude in your heart rate, but this big perfusion of blood for your arterial blood flow and your venous return is really magical. And I look at 200 meter runners when they're running 200 meters and they go 20 seconds, they finish, they're breathing hard, their sweat rate's coming down. This is great for you. So don't just go out and do 20 minutes aerobic. Make sure that you put that one segment in. And lastly, mentally allow yourself to say it's okay. And I think a lot of people just say, well, that seems kind of fluffy. 20 minutes, 95% of the time, you're going to feel better at the completion of that 20 minutes. So just do it. It's okay. You've got it done. Checked it off. Move ahead to the next day and put the planning in. Stress can be with you for a long time, and you can alleviate it by doing these short little workouts. I hope that helps. I'm Dave Scott.